All right, we move to the next sheet. That is a multi-column sheet. Now over here, basically what's happening is you've got the project code, project name, task name, resource name, etc. A lot of data provided over here, and then these project codes and all these things provided. Now I want to transform, and I'll just show you the output actually what I want it to become, so that you are in an easy way you can understand this. No, I don't think it's going to. I'll just show you the output first actually. You can till then, what we can do is we can do the get data. Okay, it's opening. You can do the, okay, I'll show you the solution since I'm here. In the tables, now if you notice over here, everyone please pay attention. So basically what we have over here is we've got this January actual hours, we've got this February actual hours, we've got the January actual cost, and we've got the February actual cost. Now what we wanted to do was we want to split this column. What we want is we want the output to look like this, where we have the month as a separate one, January, February, January, February in this manner, and the actual hours and the actual cost in another column. So basically here we have a January actual cost, February actual cost. We've got January actual hours, February actual hours. Rather, we want it to be in the format month, which is Jan, Feb, or Jan or Feb, whichever, and actual hours versus actual cost, so that with actual hours and actual cost side by side, we will be able to do the calculations. And we need another column with the month, so that month on month basis and averages and the trend analysis and all timeline basis, we will be able to do. Otherwise, with this, it is not possible to execute. Are you understanding? Here we have the Jan actual, Feb actual, Jan actual, Feb actual. Now you would understand that the problem will be Jan actual, Feb actual, Jan, sorry, actual hours, Feb actual hours, Jan actual cost, Feb actual cost, my mistake. Then you'll have March, March, April, April, May, May. Now it will not be possible for you to analyze the data, to create the timelines and the trend lines and all with the data. So therefore we need the output in this format. Now with Excel again, it is going to be a major task, and especially when you have multiple columns and thousands and lakhs of lines of data. So what do? We need to again use a pivot unpivot, right? Now how do we go about it? When we are doing this, let me go to my new untitled Power BI, where the first step, as you know, is going to be getting the Excel, that is pivot unpivot. Let me just check the name of the table. My table name was project. This table name is project. It is giving the details about the resource managers who have various projects in hand. All the projects are project one. I've deliberately kept number of lines very less in the beginning few files for you, so that it does not take a lot of time to load, right? So I hope you guys are okay with that. Now what we do is a project. So the project needs to be, the project column is what we need to, the table is what we need to load. So you can always check the name of the table by going to the design tab in the Excel file. So you know which, what is the name of the table. Once you have the name of the table here, all you need to do is you need to load the table, and see, I have the project table loaded. I think the sales is coming from the previous one that I had done. Yeah, the sales is from the previous file that I was doing, so it's continuing in the same file, that's fine. So I have my project table over here. Now obviously the first thing you do is you go to edit queries. The first thing you do is you go to edit queries. Now in the edit queries, we have the project column. Now what we would need to do is we need to transform which columns. We want January actual, February actual, January actual cost, and February actual cost. We want these four columns. Now how do you select multiple columns? You press the control button on your keyboard, and then you select all these columns at once. You have to press and hold the key control, and then you select all these four columns. Now do I want to unpivot these columns? Do I want January actual, February actual, January actual, February actual, or do I want to unpivot the other columns? Tell me, do we want to unpivot? Do we want the January actual, February actual? Then we'll segregate the actual hours and the this thing also. I'll show you. But basically, I need the January actual and the value in another column, and January, February in one column. So I need to unpivot these columns, right? I don't want to unpivot other columns. I need to unpivot these columns over here. Just follow my lead right now, unpivot columns, and you see what happens is we have these values over here in a separate column, and January actual hours, February actual hours, January actual hours, February actual hours in a separate column. I know my job is not yet done because I needed the Jan Feb in 1 month and the actual in another. Let me do one thing. Let me run through the whole file together right now. You just observe right now, and then we both will do it together. So I'll do it a little quickly, so because you're not doing it parallelly with me right now. Be a little attentive. Now what we do is, with this column, you already know how to do the delimited part. In the home tab, there is a split column option. And now by the number of characters, because each of the month is given with only 3 characters in the beginning, you could have chosen the space also, but this and the first instance of space, that is also something you could have done. I'm going to go with the number of characters, let's say, and I'll choose the number of characters 3. And repeatedly, if you do the repeatedly and okay, what happens is Jan comes in one column, then space AC in another column, T full stop space in another column, HOU in another column. But I just need it once from the left side. I just want the first 3 characters from the left side. Had I selected repeatedly, it would have let me choose show repeatedly and okay. Now there is a problem because see the first 3 characters here. The next 3 characters, AC space, you can't see the space. T dot space, you can't see that. So this has messed up the entire thing. So I'll have to, I can always cross this and cross this split column position and I can go back. So you cannot exactly do a control Z to do an undo, but you can press cross over here because these are the applied steps. You can see on the box on the right side in the query settings, this box is automatically opened over here. You can see in the box over here the applied steps. So I just cross the couple of steps that I wanted to kind of undo. You cannot do a control Z over here, right? I'll give you time to do it yourself. Right now, just focus here. So what we are going to do is we are going to split column by number of characters, and let's say 3 characters, once only from the leftmost position. From the leftmost position, you split the 3 characters once and give me the columns. So now I have these 2 columns over here. So I've got the month separated. I can of course go and rename this as month. I can just double click over here as you do, like an F2 basically in Excel, and you can rename the column heading over here. Once the column heading is done, my month has been renamed. My month has been, column has been made. But now the problem is that this attribute actual hours and value, I need to basically pivot it now. I unpivoted the data. I wanted the column headers to come repeatedly, but now I want the data in this to become the pivot header. So I need to repivot it. So basically I need to pivot this data. In the transform tab, you have the pivot. No, I think it's in the home tab itself, is it? Or the add column. One second, it was transform tab. I'm not being able to find the pivot. Once again, it was just here. Just a moment. So basically what we need to do is we need to repivot this. Pivot option does not come in the drop down actually. So I'm just checking the pivot. Okay, I'll just expand this actually. So yeah, so basically I'm habituated to seeing this. It was when it was in the minimized this restored space, the pivot table was coming over here and I was not being able to see the pivot table. I just maximize this pivot column. So I'm going to click on pivot column because I want to repivot this, right? See, don't get irritated. You will get used to this. After you do a couple of examples and all, you would know that unpivoting is what, pivoting is what, why pivot other columns, why pivot this column. It will just be a little bit of practice that you would need, a little trial and error you have to do. You click on pivot columns, and in the pivot columns, what do we want is the values column is what we want, right? In the advanced option, we have the summation. We can let it be the summation part. That is fine, I believe, and okay. And you see you've got your actual hours and actual cost over here. You see you got your actual hours and actual cost. So it was actual hours, actual cost over here. It was unpivoted. We repivoted the data, and you see the kind of output we wanted. That's exactly available now. We have the month column, we have the actual hours, we have the actual cost, and now you do your trend analysis based on month and averages and whatever analysis you want. Are you guys understanding this? I'll repeat the whole process again, and I'll go this time slow because we're going to do it parallelly. So I'm going to expect you to load the data and come to edit query quickly. That I'm not going to show. Do it quickly. Come to the edit query part. I'll close the file without saving. I'll close all my files without saving, and I'll start from scratch. File new. I'll start from scratch for you guys. Don't worry. But get the data and come to edit query quickly.
Done.
Great. So the first thing I'm going to do is get data from the Excel project, pivot unpivot Excel file. There was a table called project, if I'm not wrong. Where is it? Yeah, project, double click, load. I got this. The moment it's here, I'm going to click on edit queries. It's loading. And edit queries. The moment I'm in edit queries over here, I have this data, but now I don't like the way it has been given. January actual, February actual, January actual, February actual. So now we are together with a control key pressed. I'm going to select the four columns. Once I select the four columns, I need to unpivot these columns, not the other columns. I'm not unpivoting the other columns. I need to unpivot these columns. So unpivot columns. I think there is a mistake I made. I will need to close this. I think there was actually by mistake, I think I was holding on to another column also. Sorry. I'll need to select these four. I think I by mistake was select, I had selected by default column one also. So that made a, I made that mistake. So I'm selecting these four columns, right click, sorry. These four columns, right click, unpivot these columns. Yeah, now it's fine. I had by mistake selected the first column and the last four columns because first column was already selected. I pressed control, then I selected four columns. I was supposed to select the first, the column on the right side, then press control and select the other three columns. Are you understanding? I was already selected, the first column was selected by default. I pressed control and then selected the last four columns. So five columns were selected when I was doing this. Good. Are you understanding this much? Now with this column selected only, split by number of characters, three characters on the left side and delimit. Do this quickly. Three characters on the left side. Quickly. Done till here. We've split this much. Now all we need to do is we'll select the last two columns. These are unpivoted data. I need to repivot these two columns only. So, okay, there is no option of repivot or pivot in the drop down when you do the right click. I have to make sure that I've selected both the columns, guys, mind you. Don't just select one column to pivot. We'll select these two because these two columns need to be pivoted together. So this becomes a column header and this becomes a value underneath, right? So over here in the transform tab, you would see there is an option called pivot columns. In the transform tab, over here, if you notice, there is a pivot columns. I'll click on pivot columns. What do I want to have? I need to have the value column. I need to have the values, the value column. The value, so this value is the name over here. This value column is what I want. And I need the summation, that is fine. It's by default given summation, that's already okay. You can, we don't need the count, the number of times data is appearing. We need the data itself. We can also choose don't aggregate, but again, I'm assuming there are unique values, so it should not be an issue because for January, there should be only one data. For February, there should be only one data. But we'll still select don't aggregate. So it will just give me data as it is. It will not do any summation and all. So even if there is any duplicacy of data, it will give me in two different lines. So even if there is any duplicacy, summation would have summed up the data. So suppose I have two lines of January, actual January, actual hours, actual cost, and January, actual January cost. Actuals cannot be two for the same project. So I was doing summation because I thought it would not be a problem. But then again, we would just in case there is any duplicacy for the same manager and, you know, different managers and all. So it's better we'll go with don't aggregate and OK. The moment I do that, you see, you have the actual hours column and you have the actual cost column. Do you notice this? So we have repivoted this data. Is everyone comfortable till here? Sure. Take a minute. I'll move to the next part.